Hi everyone, and welcome to my channel. Today, I will be reading a book that's very special to me. It's called The Blue Day Book, and it was given to me by a family friend, and I've had it for years now, and it always cheers me up whenever I'm feeling down. It's essentially a animal photography book that talks about the days that you're feeling down and sad, and shines light on the dark days. So let's get started. Again, it's called The Blue Day Book, A Lesson in Cheering Yourself Up by Bradley Trevor Greive. And it was published in 2000, so it's about 19 years old now. But it's still just as wonderful. And there's a dedication here. It says, "To my wonderful parents, Faye and Trevor Greive, who never stopped taking me out to see the world, even after I was bitten by penguins. Twice." We've got some acknowledgements, but I won't go through those. I'd like to get started on the actual content. Okay. Everybody has blue days. These are miserable days when you feel lousy, grumpy, lonely, and utterly exhausted. Days when you feel small and insignificant, when everything seems just out of reach. You can't rise to the occasion. Just getting up, getting started, seems impossible. Blue days, you can become paranoid that everyone is out to get you. This is not always such a bad thing. You feel frustrated and anxious, which can induce a nail-biting frenzy that can escalate into a triple chocolate mud cake eating frenzy in the blink of an eye. On blue days, you feel like you're floating in an ocean of sadness. You're about to burst into tears at any moment, and you don't even know why. Ultimately, you feel like you're wandering through life without purpose. You're not sure how much longer you can hang on. And you feel like shouting, "Will somebody please shoot me?" It doesn't take much to bring on a blue day. You might just wake up, not feeling or looking your best. Find some new wrinkles. Put on a little weight, or get a huge pimple on your nose. Could forget your date's name, or have an embarrassing photograph published. You might get dumped, divorced, or fired. make a fool of yourself in public. Be afflicted with a demeaning nickname, or just have a plain old bad hair day. Maybe work is a pain in the butt. You're under major pressure to fill someone else's shoes. Your boss is picking on you, and everyone in the office is driving you crazy. You might have a splitting headache, or a slipped disc. Bad breath, a toothache. Chronic gas, dry lips. So cute. Or a nasty ingrown toenail. Whatever the reason, you're convinced that someone up there doesn't like you. Oh, what to do, what to do. Well, if you're like most people, you'll hide behind a flimsy belief that everything will sort itself out. And you'll spend the rest of your life looking over your shoulder, waiting for everything to go wrong all over again. All the while becoming crusty and cynical. Or a pathetic, sniveling victim. I think that's how you pronounce that. Until you get so depressed that you lay down and beg the earth to swallow you up. Or even worse, become addicted to Billy Joel songs. This is crazy, because you're only young once. And you're never old. Who knows what fantastic things are in store just around the corner? After all, the world is full of amazing discoveries. Things you can't even imagine now. There are delicious, happy sniffs and scrumptious snacks to share. Hey, you might end up fabulously rich, or even become a huge superstar one day. Sounds good, doesn't it? But wait, there's more. There are handstands and games to play. And yoga and karaoke. And wild, crazy bohemian dancing. But best of all, there's romance. Which means long, dreamy stares, whispering sweet nothings, cuddles, smooches, more smooches, and even more smooches, a frisky love bite or two. And then, well, anything goes. So how do you find that blissful, just sliding into a hot bubble bath kind of feeling? It's easy. First, stop slinking away from all of those nagging issues. It's time to face the music. Now, just relax. Take some deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. Try to meditate if you can. Go for a walk to clear your head. Accept the fact that you'll have to let go of some emotional baggage. Seeing things from a different perspective. Maybe you're actually the one at fault. If that's the case, be big enough to say you're sorry. It's never too late to do this. If someone else is doing the wrong thing, stand up tall and say, "That's not right, and I won't stand for it." It's okay to be forceful. Rarely okay to blow raspberries. Be proud of who you are, but don't lose the ability to laugh at yourself. This is a lot easier when you associate with positive people. Live every day as if it was your last, because one day it will be. Don't be afraid to bite off more than you can chew. Take big risks. Never hang back. Get out there and go for it. After all, isn't that what life is all about? I think so too. And that was the Blue Day Book. Trevor Greive. It is quite wonderful. I like it a lot. And I hope that you liked it as much as I do. As this is my first ASMR video, I will most definitely be posting more. Leave me a comment if you would like me to post more videos like this. I really enjoy reading, and I have quite a few books that I'd like to share. I have the, I believe it's called The Book of Awesome, and it essentially highlights the little things in life and all of the cool and happy things that are worth living for. So I think that I'll probably do that. Anyways, whether you're watching this at night or during the day, I hope that you enjoy the rest of your day, and I will talk to you soon.